Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. So before I even start this video, I just want to show you guys a few clips from yesterday because I didn't really vlog that much. Kalia's here but she has no shirt on, so but you guys can hear her in the background. My Pookie started soccer, which is super exciting because it's always awesome seeing a five-year-old playing soccer. Let me just say that it's so cute, it's so funny. But yeah, anyways, it's really awesome like going as a family, and I got his schedule yesterday, which is exciting. His dad will be able to see him play too when he comes next month, so that's gonna be exciting too. And yeah, I'm so excited for the season, and then he has football soon, which is even more exciting. But anyways, let me stop blabbing. This is from yesterday. I hope you guys enjoy, and then after the soccer stuff, you guys will see a whole different vlog from today, which is March 10th. All right, let me stop blabbing. Enjoy this video, you guys. And please subscribe if you haven't. And like this video, because it'll definitely help out my channel. Go, Ali.
They keep corriendo, pues nada más caminando.
Jericho's goalie. I'm trying to record. did you guys just hear Kalia say Jericho? Kalia say Jericho! Kalia say Jericho! Say Jericho!
Go!
Alina versus Jericho and the wind.
Kalia!
Ooh, good job! Ooh! Ooh, Jericho! My dad over there, where is he? Over here, do you guys see him? Just staring at them, grabbing the balls when they go his way. She is trying to go. She's like, let go of me. I want to go. My dad's grabbing the balls when it goes over there. He wants to coach them so bad.
Yeah, but
as we just saw the moon, and it doesn't do it any justice. Right now it's making it look like super bright, but it's like super orange. Let me see if I can fix this. Okay. So yeah, it looks a little better like right here because you can see the clouds in front of it and stuff. So freaking pretty. It's humongous though. Like it's literally not doing it any justice right now. But we came through this parking lot. Ooh, what's going on right now? And then I looked to the left and saw this. Oh my gosh. And now it's not focusing. Awesome. Just look at that. Good morning. Super thankful to be alive, to have another day in this beautiful world. Look at how beautiful that is. be grateful, everyone. I know I definitely am. I'm super blessed, thankful, and everything. Hello, everyone. Good morning. I do not have my hair zit, but usually this is how I be looking in the morning, honestly. I mean, y'all be seeing me. I'm about to put a little bit of foundation underneath my eyes because I forgot to bring my concealer because I look like I haven't slept in a week. And I'm gonna put on some, what's it called, mascara. This is like really dark. Okay, let me just blend it. Anyways, good morning, everyone. Welcome back to my channel. I already did what I had to do in the morning, which are my morning drop-offs, aka dropping my son off and my niece, and I have to do my eyebrows. I already dropped them off. Right now, like literally in a few minutes, I'm gonna drop off my little brother to school. And you guys, just quick update, I'm just gonna be talking to you guys for a little bit about what's been going on, because I didn't post for like 4 days. One, my freaking computer was acting crazy. And I've just been so busy, you guys, just with family stuff and also artwork, which I have been drawing this one piece that's taking forever. Like, I understand why people tell me that I need to charge more for my artwork. I just feel like I don't know. I'm not a professional artist, even though obviously I know how to draw and stuff and people love my artwork. By the way, somebody got my artwork tatted on them. I'm gonna see if I can find the video and I'll put it right here. Like, she used it as like the background of what she had already because she had a sleeve. So hashtag blessed, hashtag I'm just so happy. Like, I'm so, that just makes me feel so awesome and like, wow. But yeah, it just takes forever, you guys. So if you guys are gonna purchase an art piece from me, just know that it's gonna take a while, because it's one, it's not my main job, it's just like a side thing, and it takes a long time to draw what I draw. And I gotta delete some stuff because I can already see that, you see, I have to delete some stuff, some clips off of my camera. But yeah, you guys, my brother's about to come out here, and then when I drop him off and I come back, I'll speak to you guys a little bit more. But yeah, it's gonna be about New York. I have to just, you know, vent a little bit more about that and how I've been feeling about that whole situation of moving back to New York and all of that. So speak to you guys in a bit. And I'm back. Is there anybody behind me? Anyways, back to my New York talk, and hopefully I don't talk for too long, but I feel like I am because I always do. And why is it so freaking dark? There you go. Oh, hey girl. I posted a video yesterday speaking to you guys about how I manifested a New York apartment. I've been talking about New York for so long, and I kind of want to go into the comments of that I have been receiving. So a lot of them, of course, are like speaking about how I should think about, you know, my sister. That's mainly the main one. Like, think about your sister, you know, she's gonna have a baby soon, which she should be having her baby like the end of May-ish, beginning of June. That's basically like what everybody is saying. For those of you who are new subscribers, I moved to Virginia December 2018, because I separated with my ex. We're going through a divorce right now, which is not even like really ongoing. There's not really much happening in that department. We're just separated for now. The divorce hopefully will come soon. But yeah, we separated. I came out here mainly because I had nothing. Like, I literally had nothing to my name, no credit, nothing like that. I had been a stay-at-home mom, then I became a stay-at-home working mom. And at the time that I left, I had two jobs. I was making money, and then shit hit the fan. Once again, I still didn't have credit, so I came out here mainly because my sister is out here, and I knew she would help me with everything that I needed to, you know, I needed. She co-signed my apartment, so shout out to her, which, for those of you who don't know what that is basically like I had enough money, obviously, to rent an apartment. I just didn't make, at that time, like, for that year, I didn't make, I think it was two times the rent, that, like, you need to make two times the rent in order to, like, get the apartment. So I needed to have her income and my income in order to get my apartment. So she did that, and shout out to her. And she just helped me a lot throughout this whole journey. In August, a car that was mine through marriage, it was in my ex's name, got repossessed because of certain things on his part. I have been using my sister's car ever since. So she's been helping me a lot. I've been helping her a ton as well. She doesn't feel good. Like, we help each other out. So she's a huge part of my life, and I'm a huge part of her life. We've always been really close. So recently I spoke to somebody who I haven't spoken to in a really long time. Long story short, they have an apartment that is gonna be going for rent. Actually in June, because that person's moving in June, so that's like the earliest, you know. And so for me, I just wanted to address that whole situation. As far as my sister, I feel like for the past few months, you guys, I've been thinking about New York so much. When I first moved here, like, or when I first separated with my ex, aka husband, whatever you want to call it, I thought about moving to New York, but then that thought quickly brushed out of my freaking mind because New York rent is super expensive. Let me turn off the car. And there are obviously certain parts of New York that are not good, and just like everywhere, there's certain parts of everywhere that's not good, and there's also good parts. But yeah, that like left my brain because it's so expensive out there as far as renting. So I made the choice to obviously come here, and I know that I would have help with my sister and her family. But fast forward to a year and 3 months, there is now this apartment that has manifested. I've been thinking about New York for so long because, for those of you who don't know, YouTube is my job / career. I wanted to get to a point where I am making a salary that I am 100% proud of. Like right now, I'm, you know, getting by. You know, I am, I can pay my rent, I can pay my bills. I can be doing better. I feel like that's just how life is. But now I have this opportunity to, you know, take that offer and move to New York. The rent is $1,100. I know that I would make more money living in New York. Let's just say that. I know for a fact. I get invited to events out there, mainly in California, but I'm not moving to California. That's just way too damn far. But I know that I would network over there. And I lately have been thinking so much about my future, especially financially, because, you know, I have two kids. Oh, I see a cardinal. Oh my gosh. He's so freaking cute. Let me show y'all really quick. Look at him. You guys, I never see this bird. It's crazy because, I don't know if you guys know this, but if you ever see a cardinal, I believe that's what they're called, it's because, like, someone who has passed in your life is, like, showing you signs that they're around or that they're okay. Which is so crazy. And it's crazy because a certain person popped into my head right now. But that lives in New York. Or lived in New York. Anyway, so what was I saying? I don't even know where I'm going with this. It's just, there's just been so much on my mind. Yeah, just financially, I just want to grow, obviously. Who doesn't? And it's not a thing where I want to go to New York because New York is so popping and New York is so beautiful. And it's not a thing where I love New York. Oh my gosh, like the living over there is amazing. No, it's just a thing where I just know I would make more money living out there. So, like here, there's not really, it's really slow pace. There's not much to do. I'm literally doing the same thing every single day, and I get it. I could be doing stuff as well out here, but I've also been on a budget. There's also things that you can do free, but it's like I also don't have a car. I am, you know, depending on my sister's car and stuff like that for now. Whereas in New York, you know, the second you come out of your building, let's say, there's just everything, like bodega, restaurants, stores, people. There's just so much going on. Whereas here, you go outside, nobody's even walking around, you know, it's just completely different. And it'll just be more interesting for not only myself and my kids, but for, you know, the viewers. And once again, this is my job, so that's the type of thing I just think about all the time. And it's not like I could just jump and go anywhere that I want, you know? So I have been really feeling like trapped and like in a box lately. And I haven't really expressed it like that much on the channel, but I have my days where I kind of get anxiety as well. Like this is just not what I want to be doing right now. Like, I don't want to be doing the same thing over and over. And living in New York, I could just picture myself. Like, I've lived in New York before. I know the good parts and the bad parts. Like, I know, you guys. You guys have been saying in the comments, like, I don't know, but I know, you guys. I know the places where I would want my kids to be and where I don't want my kids to be. And that's another thing that you guys say, like, raising kids in New York is, like, not good or whatever. I have a lot of family that live in New York and their kids are great. And they don't even live in the best parts either. But I'm not going to be raising them over there. They're just going to be there for a brief moment. If I do move over there, it will just be literally for a year and a half. Like a year or a year and a half until they're... father comes to Virginia, God willing. That would be awesome. He will be retiring in about 2 years, I think. So I would want to obviously be back by the time he comes back. And that's another thing too that, like, I see in the comments, like, oh, consider, you know, think about your baby daddy, you know, co-parenting. And that's like one of the first things that I thought about. And the things that are on my mind is my sister, obviously, and helping her. And obviously co-parenting, which, like I said, I would be back by the time he gets here. But then it's like, as far as everything else, I'm like, I have a life too. And I get it. I don't want to sound selfish or anything like that. But like, my future is important as well. And my happiness is important as well. And, you know, we've helped each other a lot. And I also need to think about my future and financially, and how, like, I just know that I'm not, like, that I'm gonna be financially stable if I were to move over there. I read something that says, like, if something is constantly calling you, like, just do it, because who wants to live with what ifs? And life is so short, and I don't want to miss out on a great opportunity, you know? Like, this will just be, like, such an amazing opportunity. But then it's also, once again, I gotta think about the kids as well. Obviously, that was actually one of the first things I thought about, like, getting Jericho out of school. They're both so young still, so they wouldn't even remember this, I don't think. But maybe Jericho a little bit. But that's another thing, like, moving him over there and the bond that he has with my niece and all of that. So it's just a lot. Don't know what the fuck to do. But I also need to, like, mommy needs to be happy too, you know? And obviously, I also need to be financially stable and be at a place where I know I'm gonna be making money, you know? But yeah, so that's where my mind is with that. I don't know, you guys. It's just, this is a hard decision. And I don't even know when I would be able to do it. And for those of you, everything that I've ever done my whole life, the first thing that I ever think about is the kids, of course, obviously. And before it was my ex, they were always the first thing. They were the main priority, obviously. And now it's like, damn, I want to kind of do something for myself, and I still can't get it out of me to, or go out of my way to actually do something that I know would be good for me, you know? As selfish as that might sound, because even in my head, that sounds selfish, but it's like, I also have to put myself, or make myself, a priority as well. And even doing this move or whatever, it's not even just thinking about me. Like, it's thinking about my kids' future as well, because I want to be financially stable and I want to build my brand, not for me, but to make sure that I'm stable for my kids, you know, financially stable for my kids and their future. Anyways, that's what's been on my mind for the past few days. And I don't know what the fuck to do, but we'll figure something out, you know. We shall see. I'll keep you guys updated.
From the first time I saw ya, you were not like the others. A cool kind of melody. You rattled my cage without warning. Kept it upright till the morning.
I look crazy. So you guys, right now I'm currently in my sister's car. If it looks like I was crying, it's because I was. I have been on my phone watching like Ellen episodes and American Idol episodes as well, like little clips of it. And you know, the stories behind Ellen episodes and American Idol are always like very sentimental, so I was crying. I was in the car because my sister had a doctor's appointment, so I was literally just in here on my phone. Kalia's knocked out. And we came to MP's International. This is in Newport News, Virginia. And you guys, this place has the best Jamaican food. They also have a location in Norfolk. And it's so freaking good. I love MP's. I've literally been coming here since I first got to Virginia, like, what, 7 years ago already? Yo, so freaking good. Like in the beginning when I first, you know, met my kids' father and all of that, MP's is the shiznit. Like, so good. And then also here is this one is a supermarket as well. Let me show you. They have like a bunch of Caribbean food that you can find here, and a bunch of like a bunch of things that I use, like canilla rice and goya, platanos, all of that. They have that in this place, like a bunch of Caribbean and Hispanic foods. So the only thing is that this place is like out of the way, so I never come here. But yeah, this place is bomb. Anyways, my sister just went inside to get some Nutramet, aka Nutramet. I think that's how you say it in English. It's like a energy drink type of thing, and she freezes it and eats it like ice cream. My family has literally been doing that for years. She got it from my dad. My dad used to do that when we were young. I always remember him eating it from the can like it was freaking ice cream, and he passed it on to my sister, so she eats it like that. And even to this day, my dad eats it like that too. So yep. And then Thursday, she has so many appointments as well, so I think I'm just gonna bring my laptop with me. I'm gonna make sure that it's charged, and I'm gonna bring my art book with me as well so I can draw, because she's going to be so busy. She has 3 appointments, and I'm literally just gonna be in the car waiting for her with Kalia. So yeah. Oh, since I'm here, let me speak to you guys about what's been going on with my sister. I haven't told you guys because I didn't know if I should. So I asked her the other day if I can speak to you guys about it, and she said she didn't mind. So here I am speaking about it. A lot of you guys have been asking about her health and all of that, and let me put this damn window up. And she has been up and down, you guys, like mainly down as far as her body. Like when she first got pregnant, you know, she had the regular symptoms, tired, and you know, morning sickness and all of that, being nauseous. And she was still working. She works in retail. And then I think it's been I don't even know how long it's been already, but she would go to work, and she works a lot. That's why when you guys ask about like what happened to their vlogs, like they work, you know, they're always at work. They work long hours. So that's what she would do. That took a huge toll on her body, where I feel like her body was telling her like, girl, you need to relax. She would go to work and always throw up. She would always be coughing, and then she started noticing that she wouldn't be able to breathe. So that happened to me when I was pregnant, but I ended up having asthma when I was pregnant, and my doctor gave me an asthma pump or whatever. So, and also she was getting the chills, fevers and stuff like that. Like her body was just kind of like basically telling her like, okay, I need to like shut down, I need to relax type of thing. But obviously she has to go to work. So one day she went to work, and one of her coworkers was like, you can't like do this to your body. Like your body's literally giving up on you right now, because she would have the chills at work and get fevers and stuff. So long story short, right now she has to go to a bunch of appointments, and she's had a bunch of appointments so that she can get a letter from her doctor telling her job that she basically can't work anymore. And she hasn't worked for a couple weeks, I believe, because of this breathing issue. And she actually got blood work done, and they told her that she possibly can have a blood clot in her lungs. She got that checked out, and it wasn't a blood clot, but they did notice that her artery, like her main artery that goes to her heart, is enlarged. So that is the reason why she cannot breathe at certain times. And it's just crazy how every pregnancy is different, because she didn't obviously have to go through this with Alina. So yeah, she has an enlarged artery and it's just been really hard on her. Like, I don't remember the last time that I've seen her good for a few days. Like, she has her moments every single day where she doesn't feel good. So yeah, that's what she's dealing with right now, which is why for the most part I try my best whenever she feels that way I take Alina, because she can't really do a lot. I just want her to feel better. It really sucks that she is dealing with all this stuff right now. You know, as long as her and the baby are good, that's all that matters. But yeah, pregnancy is rough, man. It can be, it's such a blessing, but women are so strong because they got to go through so much like this. So yeah, but I'm excited and she's also excited, and we're looking forward to her baby shower, which is going to be in the beginning of April. And I don't know if I should tell you guys the theme, but it's going to be really cute. But she's coming right now, but I kind of want to tell you guys, I'm going to put her link to her registry down below. You guys don't have to purchase anything, like, do don't feel pressured, but I'll put it down there. Yes,
you want your own? I got one so we can share, but I didn't know if you want one because it's $4.99.
What? I was just talking about this. What did you get?
Look,
hold up. Yeah, go down to the underneath this video and it'll be there. Oh, yeah. Oh, yummy. I usually don't get jerk chicken. I never tasted it, but it looks yummy. Look at that, you guys. Okay, Carla just said, oh wait,
I mean,
that the chicken is super spicy. I never get jerk chicken when I come here. I told you guys I usually get oxtail or stewed chicken.
It's only $4.99 with the soda.
With the soda?
Yes. Goya. Which
one? I still want to taste this though.
Yeah, it's good though, but it just has a kick to it. Spicy
cream. Oh fuck. Too much for me to enjoy my food. Like, I'm gonna be constantly thinking about the spice. All right, you guys, I'm actually gonna come in here and get some because it's $4.99 for that plate and a soda. So okay, let me come in here. I'm gonna put my camera down on. Of awesomeness. Stewed chicken with rice and peas and mac and cheese. Yum. And they put a lot. Like, damn, that's a lot.
Exactly. All four.
This was all
$5.
$5. Well, $5.60.
Yeah, but that's tax.
That's freaking awesome. Literally yesterday we spent five something on a freaking cheeseburger and shit in freaking McDonald's. And look at this. There's gonna be leftovers and everything, hopefully. Give me your hand. Thank you. You're so beautiful, mama. Say hi. Come on. Come on. Yeah, we gotta, oh, why is it dark? There you go. We gotta return some shin guards that we bought the other day because for some reason the ones that I bought didn't come with like straps, which I don't get, but what are you doing? She just let go of my hand to look at shorts. You're looking for it for Jericho? That's for Jericho, Kalia? Oh, anyways, back to what I was saying about my sister's registry link. I'm gonna put it down below. Once again, don't feel pressured to get anything, but I'm gonna put it down below because a few of you guys asked me what her registry is. And can I just say, can you hold my hand, mama? Come on, let's go. Run. Can I just say how appreciative I am for you guys? Like, for you guys to love and support my family as well, you know? You guys watch my channel, but you guys love my family as well. Like, you guys have been seeing my sister since the beginning, obviously. It's been 5 years, so I know you guys also feel that love for her too, and I appreciate it. So I'm gonna put her registry link down below. She doesn't know that I'm putting it, so I'm sure she'll be surprised. But once again, thank you for all of the love and support and for her baby shower. I'll make sure that if anything gets there, we'll open it up for on her baby shower. Yes, you don't want it, put it on like that, mama. Wow. Where are you going, Mama? Where are you going? Bye-bye. I see you later. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. You're so cute, Mama. I love you so much. Go to Tia. Look. Tia. Look at Tia right there. Look. Over there. Over there. Go. Go. Say hi, Tia.
I'm not even white, but what do you think of these?
Yeah, they're fine.
They're like $9. That's okay.
Oh yeah, clear instruction.
I know that.
Where are you going now, Mama? You don't play golf? Ball, yeah. Oh my God, how cute would she look with a tennis outfit? Why did I say tennis? What the hell? With like one of those golf outfits or even a tennis outfit. Would look so cute. And with a little stick or golf thing. You can tell I don't play golf. Excuse me, miss, that is not yours, and that is also $40, so keep it there. Thank you. Go to Tia. I'm gonna get you. Bye bye.
Come on, Kalia.
Hi, you are so cute, Mama. Thank you. Oh, besito.
Oh. Thank you. I love your kisses. Like that.
What that? Kalia, come over here. Come on. Come over here. Come over here. Do you have anything to say to them? No. Do you have anything to say?
No.
You don't? You don't want to say anything? Wee. Okay. Okay, girl. I see you. Nothing else? Do you want to tell them where you are? Kalia? Okay, if you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, stomp your feet. You don't want your jacket? Can I just mention that it's like 70 Yay! Degrees outside? Yay! Why? You're so cute, Mama.
Ba.
Where did your tia go? Let's go to Tia. Where did she go? I don't know where Tia went. Come on. Ah! No. Bing. Dame tu mano.
No.
Oh, girl. She is such a little sassy girl. Where is Tia? You just be distracting me, Kalia. You know this?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going this way. Oh, Tia's over here. Tia's over here. Come, come, come.
Yeah.
She's all the way over there. How did she get over there in such a small amount of time? Come on, let's go.
Yeah.
Say Tia.
Tia.
I love that she says Tia now because she literally learned it like 2 days ago. Say Tia. Yeah. Carlos, she's going like this. Look with her hand. She's going like this. Tia. Tia. That's Tia. Yay. Give Tia a hug. Aww. Wow, you guys, how is this $2.29 when you could get it in Dollar Tree for a dollar?
Wow.
You guys, I just got home. My sister just dropped me off. She'll be back later on to leave the car. But this is the soda that it comes with. Hold up, puppy. I don't think that's something that you eat, baby. That's not what you eat, puppy. Eat this right here. Okay, hold on. You don't hit. That's not nice. You don't hit either. Anyways, we are literally all sharing from this plate, which is freaking huge.
Can I get more?
Yes, wait. This is like an amazing deal for $5.60. This is worth so much more, but they had so many people on that line. Anyways, we're gonna continue enjoying this yumminess over here. She's ready, so let's go. Hey guys, so it is currently 6 p.m. and it is March 10th, so I'm so excited because I'm gonna be posting this early earlier than expected because technically the end of people's vlogs is the end of their day, but it's not the end of my day whatsoever. I still gotta fold a shitload of clothes, because recently my sister's dryer broke and I've been drying all of her freaking clothes. I haven't, like, we've been taking turns cleaning clothes and it's been a lot, y'all. Anyways, I gotta fold a bunch of clothes and I gotta clean my room. Now that, like, I'm like 100% sharing my room with the kids, and hopefully soon I can decorate my room in a way where it's like my kids in my room. So Jericho's gonna get a little bed in here. You guys will see. I'll vlog the process once I, you know, have my budget and my money to spend on extra furniture for this room. So just stay tuned. Anyways, oh, and once again, I'm gonna put the link to my sister's registry down below for those of you who have been asking. And whenever her baby shower comes, we will open up whatever she gets from the family, friends, and YouTube fam that day. And I'm so excited for that, you guys. And also, her birthday is coming up on the 28th. We will be planning an New York baby shower because we got family all over the place. The one for here is going to be for Simon's family, her friends that are here, and her co-workers. And then most of our family is in New York. So we're going to do one in my mom's house. And around that time, like I said, we're going to be planning her baby shower because it's going to be like May, like 1st or something, or 2nd. So I'm pretty sure she's not going to be expecting, like, you know, a theme or anything like that for her birthday, for, you know, the time that we go to New York. But I want to plan something for her because, you know, since we're going to be so busy with the baby shower, she's probably going to forget. Like, she probably thinks that we're going to get her cake or something, but I want to get her, like, a really good, like, themed cake, and also want her to dress a certain way for her birthday. So let me know. I have some ideas, but let me know if you guys have any themes in mind for her. Hopefully she doesn't watch this vlog. She don't be watching all of my vlogs, like, all the way through anyways, but let me know. For my birthday, she did a 90s theme. She's an amazing party planner. I'm not, like, I'm an editor. Like, I edit videos, and she's amazing at party planning and decorating and stuff. So she did a 90s theme. My cake was filled with my artwork and also, like, boombox, CDs, anything that from the 90s, all of that stuff was on the cake. So I want to have, like, a little theme for her as well for her actual birthday. She's going to be turning 32, so yeah. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. Once again, the link is going to be down below. Please subscribe to my channel if you have not. And please like this video because, once again, it'll definitely help out my channel. Thank you guys for all of the feedback that you have been giving me in the video where I spoke about, you know, moving to New York and all of that. I feel, like, more at ease right now. There's always just so much on my mind when it comes to that, but let me not even get into it because I've already been speaking for almost 4 minutes. So I'll speak to you guys later. Love you guys, and you guys will see us tomorrow. Peace out.
I ruined my dad, the rib, my dad.